One of our primary goals at the Institution of None and All is a better understanding of evolution, a better way of using evolution. We would like evolution to be something that human beings get and are participating in actively, consciously, and with real intent. That's critical and necessary if the world wants to save itself from the disaster that you people have created for yourselves. So when we're talking about evolution of human beings, the tendency I think for most people is to think about physical evolution and to go back millions of years to what's now, I believe, Ardipithecus, and try to create the chain of events that takes our great-great ancestors, who are small chimpanzee-like bipedal tree-dwelling, partially, you know, invested in grassland savanna ecosystems, and turning them into human beings of today. There's several event horizons between that point and now. One of them is the advent of the time within about 100,000 years that we start to see evidence of grave goods, we see evidence of rock art, we see evidence of sculpture, we see evidence of a relationship with the natural universe that is more than just material. It's metaphorical. It has meaning now. Humans begin to create things that are beyond just what you need to dig up tubers and start a fire and put up shelter and kill an animal. That's the advent of religion. That's the event horizon in the human evolutionary timeline that signifies that humans are doing something that it has meaning and is beyond them. And beyond their simple needs. So at that point, you know, we have a very good idea of how their religion at that time worked. We understand animism, we understand the relationship of the human being to the environment, how important it is for them to identify with their prey, with their surroundings. It's critical to the survival of the species at this point to create a relationship, a metaphorical, meaningful, working, spiritual relationship with the land and with the other inhabitants of the planet, the animals and the plants. That's how we begin to acquire the knowledge and the sophistication necessary to launch states. It's how we go from just being brutish, a brutish species where only the strongest determine everything by the strength of force and dominance alone, which is where we're still now today. And what we're trying to do is punch through that barrier and get to the next event horizon, where it's not the strength of arms, but the strength of our collective will and our collective sense of ourselves. We went from an animistic period into a period where the church and the spirit split. The spirit has always gone with individuals. It doesn't matter what group they're from. It doesn't matter what language they spoke. It doesn't matter what time they were in. All of the great mystical individuals of this planet who have defined the religious experience as it moves forward and evolves, all of them described a way of being that is consistent. It's comprehensive, it's basic, and it's well known, and there isn't any excuse for anyone not to know it anymore. And we're not going to talk about that anymore because it's another lesson for another time. The church, on the other hand, splits in two evil even ways. One is to do good for people collectively, and one is to do harm to them collectively. One of them institutes all this horror and war, and it's really that's a separate issue in human nature that doesn't really have anything to do with true religion. It doesn't have anything to do with the spirit of religion. It doesn't have anything to do with the mystical side of things. So when you approach the matrix, phylogenous web, the matrix of the subject of religion, you have to take into account the quality of the mystical actions of the people, the time, the place, the historicity. It's all tied in there. And if people go the way of the animistic spirit, then they don't create the horror and the inherent problems in religion. They arrive at collectivism through a peaceful and egalitarian means, and that's what religion is supposed to do and not the other, and that's my time.